Nab it. Snap it. Chop it. That's the way. Every day, you can play Beat the Clock. And now, here's the star of the all-new Beat the Clock, Monty Hall.
Well, here we are, and you got to know it's Beat the Clock when you see something like this. You know that it's a fun way to start the day, and we're going to be starting it off with a stunt that involves these inner tubes in just a few seconds. And helping us along will be the loveliest things that ever went inside an inner tube. And that is, we have our three lovely ladies over here, and we have Autumn and Cindy and Lisa all set to play Beat the Clock with our contestants. We'll see you later, kids, if you can jump out of these tubes. And I'm going to jump right out and meet our first two teams that are going to play the game when Jack Nars introduces them.
Well, Monty, our champs are back, having won $10,100 so far. Brad Kovar and Suanne Feifner. Challenging them, financial analyst from Twardy, David Toth, and his favorite gal, Sally Miller.
All right, David Toth and Sally Miller, how are you? David, Sally, good to see you. The new green team, the new challenging team. David Toth, tell me something about yourself.
Well, Monty, I'm a financial analyst for a large aerospace company out in Ontario, California.
Financial analyst.
Right.
Maybe you could analyze and do something for Suanne and Brad later. They want so much money, they may need some financial advice.
They're going to need a tax expert pretty soon.
That's right. Sally, while he's doing all this advice, what do you do?
I'm a secretary for a large engineering corporation in Pasadena.
Very good. Pasadena, and you're out in Ontario, so you're not too far away from each other, about 20 miles, right?
Yeah.
But you finally managed to get together once in a while.
She forces me.
That's the way it always is, they tell me. Now, Brad and Suanne, as you know, you've made about $10,000, and I understand that since you knocked off our bonus stunt, you got some special T-shirts made. Do you want to show us what those T-shirts say? I beat the clock. Yes, and you sure did. You sure did beat the clock. You have $10,000 and change, as we say. And, you know, it's been so long since I asked you what you did, you got to refresh me again.
I forgot.
I mean, what was it you used to do before you got rich?
I worked for a free restaurant information service called Dine Line.
Well, tell me how that works, without mentioning any restaurants, but do I just call you and tell me what's a good place to go to, what?
Right, we have toll-free numbers throughout Southern California, and if you're looking for a good, decent place to eat anywhere in the Southern California area, you call certain numbers and you will get information on, honest information on restaurants that...
I see, you give out, you impart this information, do you?
Right.
Uh-huh. Suanne, do you go out and help Brad to check out these restaurants to see how the food is?
Now, meanwhile, I'm back at the farm working with the kids, camp counselor.
Oh, I see. I'm kind of relieved here by seeing different names that you are. Oh, yes, you are the camp counselor, right. And how many children do you have to look after?
I have 12.
Yeah, 12 kids that you look after. Okay, Suanne and Brad, you have some new formidable challenges. You're going to try and go after your title today. And gentlemen, I'm going to ask you to do the first stunt for me, if you will. David and Brad, see if you can come all the way around these tubes and come down to the other side of the stage with me. We line up behind these tubes, and this is going to be a race. I will ask you, gentlemen, to place 1 foot in each tube as so, right? Like that. Each of you will do that to begin with. And then you're going to move down into center stage where you'll pick up two more tubes without using your hand. Just by using your feet, you manipulate so that you'll each have two tubes on each foot, right? Mm-hmm. Then continue on and get another pair on your feet, and then you'll have three on each foot, right? Mm-hmm. Any questions so far?
None at all.
Then you turn around and get back here to the finish line and break the tape that the girls will be holding for you. The first one back is going to be the winner. Or if no one is back but is leading, when 60 seconds is up, that person will be the winner. Are you ready, gentlemen? Question.
We put one on top of the other one. Pick
no, no. Well, I don't know how you do it, but I want you to get down there. I want you to have two on each foot and no hands. How you do it is up to you. Okay? Are you ready? Go. Shuffle along now. That's right. They got the idea. He's got the idea. Here they come, girls. Here they come. Here they come. Here comes the green one. Green one has a lead. Will he be able to hold that lead? Poor Brad can't get the third one on. Green one is having some trouble. Now he's coming. Now they're both coming. Now it's going to be... Oh! The red team wins! Whoa! Come on back to the girls. That, I tell you, that is a come-from-behind win. He was way back here. I don't know what happened. I don't know what happened to David. David was just about 10 feet from the finish line. All of a sudden, he started going sideways. And along comes Brad and makes a hurtling finish and wins by a mustache, by the width of his mustache. And the red team gets $500. Have you got your breath back?
Yeah, I've got it back.
Because that was fun.
You want to do it again?
Yeah, let's do it again. That was great.
This time we'll ask you to do six on each foot and see how much fun it is. Brad and Suanne, come. We're going to play a game right over here involving the two of you. Suanne, I'm going to ask you to stand on this mat right over here, okay? And Brad, no, Brad's going to go over here. You're going to stay back there, Suanne. Brad, you come right over here. And we're going to have you throw balloons over to Suanne. Suanne is going to break them, and that's all there is to it. And all she has to do, all she has to do is break two of these balloons, and you'll have yourself another $500. The time on the clock for this stunt is... Oh, 55 seconds. That should be a snap, right?
Right.
Oh, sure, you just bat the balloons back to her. Oh, incidentally, I want you to turn your back to her when you do bat the balloons, okay? Right. Will you do that? Okay. And I must... turn around. That's what I meant in the first place. Now, Brad, when I say bat the balloons, I mean bat the balloons, because if you just throw them over your head, they'll fall to the ground. And if they fall to the ground, that won't work, because you won't be able to break them. You know why?
What?
Now you can turn around and see why. Because we have special apparatus for her to break the balloons with. First, the blindfold on Suanne. And then a special hat. And this hat, my dear friends, has pins on the end of it. And when a balloon lands on top of that hat, that will burst the balloon. Now, as you can see, when we put this hat on Suanne, she won't know where the balloon is. That's where we get back to you again. Because, Brad, you will bat the balloon in the air, and then you run back, and you grab her.
Uh-huh.
That's the good part.
Yeah, yeah.
And then you steer her under the balloon.
Oh, can I lift her up?
You can do anything you want, but she has to break it with the top of her hat.
Okay.
Okay? Now, when that is done, that will be one. And then you get her back on the mat, you get back on the mat, and you do it again until you break two. Now, if you fail to break it, it lands on the ground. Of course, you can't get it back up in the air. You have to come back and do a balloon.
No problem.
Now you can turn around. And when I say bat them, take one at a time, and really bat it up high, because that'll give you more time to get her under it. Ready? You have to go and steer her under it. Ready? How much time do we have for this? 55 seconds? You have to break two. Ready? Go. There he goes. Now he's going to steer her under the... He got one. All right. Back and back. Good. Now go back in a second. This kid knows what he's doing. Not going to get anywhere with you. No. All right, go back, get another one. Go back, get another one. All right, lots of time. Here we go. Ah, boy. There you are. Okay, my dear. Be careful with those needles. There you go. All right. Very well done, Sue. I'll take the sticky one, and you can hold on to the blindfold. There you are. Another $500 for the champions, and doing just jolly well. And we'll come back in just a minute to see if the ladies can engage in a little contest to see who wins $500. That'll take place right after this takes place. Welcome back to Beat the Clock. A moment ago, I said the ladies are going to have their chance to win some money, but they're going to do it in concert with the men. This is going to be a couples event. So if I can have the gentleman, the green gentleman over here, red gentleman over there, sitting down on the chair. Ladies, I want you to take positions on the mats corresponding to your color, facing your man. All right? Facing your man. You got a man backstage? This way. That's right. Face over here. That's good. All right. Now, here's what we're going to do. We're going to have a little bagel passing contest, because in the center over here, we have a tray full of fresh bagels. If you get tired of this particular stunt and want to stop and enjoy it, you may, but I'd advise you to try and win $500. Here's what's going to happen. You're going to pass the bagel along to your wife. She, in turn, is going to turn around and get it inside that bowl, which is at the other side. Do you want to turn around and spot it? There it is. Okay. Now, what you're going to have to do is get two of them into that bowl. Team that gets it first is going to be the winner. Now, here's what happens. You will start by placing your heads back, all the way back. I shall place a bagel to start off with right on your forehead and do one on each. Now, you will go and pass this to your wife, forehead to forehead, and you can do anything. You can touch her and so on, but you cannot touch the bagel. As soon as you've passed it on, come back and sit, and as soon as one is in the bowl, our girls will place another one on your forehead. The first team to get two will be the winner. We have 60 seconds. Let's see if we can get a winner or a leader in that time. Are you ready, gentlemen? Ready, go. If you drop the bagel, come back to the starting line. All right, look at the green team. And here comes the red team right behind him. Now you have to get it into the bowl. Gentlemen, go right back to your chairs. Go right back, go right back. Go back to your chair, go back to your chair. All right. Here you go. Green team has a lead. Red team right behind them. No hands, no hands, no hands. You can't use your hand. Go back another one. No hands. No hands. Go back another one. It's a tie game. It's a tie game with 10 seconds to go. Tie game with 5 seconds to go. Here you go. And green team wins! Green team! Green team wins! All right. Green team in a photo finish wins. And here's an extra bagel for the audience. Okay. Now then, back to your seats. Let's put up $500 on the board for the green team, David Toff and Sally Miller. Why are you resting? I'm ready to go again, aren't you?
That's hard work.
Is that hard work? Well, if that was hard work, I've got hard work coming up for you again, because this time, of course, you'll work as a team, not against them, but against the clock. Catch a good, deep breath, because it's going to be a tough one for you. It'll involve a lot of running around. Okay. Now, you have 500 bucks. You're going to try and get another 500 if you can do this stunt. Okay? All right. Now, they're setting up something very interesting for you, and I'll take you back. And I will sit you on stools. Each of you will take a stool and face each other, and I'll explain this stunt to you, okay? All right, let's go. One on each stool. There you go. Now I want you to turn around and take a look and see what we have on your left and on yours, or your right over here. Do you see that you have a table full of hats? You have a table full of hats. Now turn around, I'm going to tell you something about those hats. They are identical. They're the same number of hats on each table, and they represent the same hats. There's a duplicate of each hat back there. What I'm going to ask you to do is when I say go, you'll run back, pick out a hat, put it on, come back, sit down, shake hands. If you're wearing the same hat, that's a match. Get two matches in the time we have for you, and you will win your $500. There's one other thing I should tell you, and the other thing is you can't wear the same hat twice. You've got to come back and change hats. The time to get two is on the clock. And how much time do we have for them in this stunt? 55 seconds. All right. Are you ready? Remember, take a hat, come back, shake hands, and I'll tell you how you're doing. But don't wear the same hat twice. Ready? Go. Look at this. Look at this. Very good. Time's a match. All right. Look at these kids. They've got the first one right off the bat. Stop the clock. Hold it. Hold it. I have got to tell you something. I'm going to tell the audience something. You will not believe this. You know that we pretest all these stunts. We go over them and over them and over them to make sure that they can be done, and sure they can be done in the time that we set for them. Otherwise, we don't use the stunt. In rehearsals and trying the stunt, I have yet to see anybody do two. They've come very close. I've seen people do one. They not only did two, they did it with the first two they put on. And let me tell you something else. If you noticed that on the tables, the hats were all scrambled up, so the first one wasn't the first one on the other table and so on, they just had to go by their hunches and grab a hat, and they did it. It is absolutely fantastic. Fantastic. All right. Another $500 for the green team, bringing their total up to $1,000. And in a moment, we'll go back with both teams to play the bonus shuffle to determine who plays the bonus round today. That'll be exciting. Well, we're back again to resume Beat the Clock, and this time we're going to play what we call our bonus shuffle. The bonus shuffle with this bonus shuffleboard is graded into money amounts that range from $300 all the way up through $4, $5, $6, $7, $8, $9, up to $1,000. Now, the disc that touches the highest amount of money, that's the team that's going to win the game, and have the right to go on and play the bonus round. They get the amount of money they touch and play the bonus game for 10 times that amount. Okay? Just remember that when you toss that disc down, if it goes off the end or off the sides, it doesn't count. And if it doesn't reach as far as 300, it doesn't count. It has to be in play. Now, because both teams are tied in money amounts at $1,000 apiece, they each have two discs to play with. Nobody has the advantage there. And before the show, in case of a tie, we had a toss. The red team won the toss. They will determine whether they want to go first or last.
Last.
Want to go last. Okay, ladies go first. Sally, you'll have the first shot with the green. Suanne will be next. And then we'll follow along with David, and Brad will come up in the last position. Are you ready? Here goes. Are you a sideways shuffler? Okay, here she goes. Oh, now she's a front way shuffler. Here goes Sally. She likes going to the side. Here she goes. Too much, and off the board, and that isn't going to count at all. There's a big advantage for the red. The champion, Suanne, is going to go next. Suanne has a very gentle toss, passes 3, 4, 5, and touches $600. David, this is the one you've got to beat. This is the one you've got to beat, David. This is your last shot, $600. Okay, let's see how he does with this one. Oh, David doesn't even go far enough. He goes off the board. Now, Mr. Red Team, Brad, here is your decision. Hold it. If you want, you can quit right now, win the 600, and go on to play the bonus for 6,000. However, you have one more disc. You may try and go for a higher amount, but you never know what happens when you shoot a disc down the table. All right, Brad, he may try for 1,000. No. He's happy with his $600. So Brad and Suanne add $600, and they'll be back to play a brand new bonus game for $6,000 right after these messages. We're back, and our champions have earned the right to play our bonus stunt, and you're going to be playing this bonus stunt for $6,000, right, Brad?
That's right.
As you can see, it's a brand new one, and it's a little game of horseshoes. Shoo-be-doo-be-doo is what we call this one, and all you have to do is manipulate the board so that the ping pong balls go and end up with one in each horseshoe, right? When you can get all five of them in like that with some dexterity, which you have shown us so far on the show, you'll be getting $6,000 for this, provided you do it within the time limits. And here's the time on the clock. 40 seconds. All right. So now you'll be hollering out all kinds of instructions. And are you ready? Go.
Lift up. Lift up. Lift up. Get them all down here. Okay. Oh, nice and easy.
Now you've got one. Now you've got two. Now you've got one. Now you've got two again. Now you've got three. You've got 10 seconds. Now you've lost them. Now you've got two again. Now you've got three, but you got two in this hole. Now you've got four. Now you've got three. Now you haven't got any. His time is up. All right. All right. Now, kids, maybe you didn't get it this time, but I recall that you couldn't get the coin either, and you stayed on the show long enough to manipulate your way into a big bonus with that one. And who knows, you may come back again tomorrow and be the champions and have another shot at this game. And if you do, of course, you'll win a lot more money. So you didn't get the $6,000, but you did pick up a lot of dough on today's show, and we'll be doing a lot of totaling up in just a moment. And you watch these messages, and then we'll be back with the totals for both teams for today. Well, David Toth and Sally Miller, you didn't hang around here too long. Just one day, in that one day, you picked up $1,000. That's quite good. But you'll be forever remembered on Beat the Clock for having performed that hat stunt in consecutive moves. I doubt if it'll ever be done again in history. So you'll remember that a long time. Play it with your friends and see how it works out. And take our $1,000 and thank you for being with us. David and Sally, good luck to both of you. Brad and Suanne at $1,600 to their winnings. What is their new total now on Beat the Clock? They're all the way up to $11,700. Now, I got to tell you a little secret. We found it in our audience. Brad's father's in the audience, and he applauded so hard the other day for his son. Look what happened to him. Take a picture of him. You see it right over there? He's the guy with the broken arm. He broke his wrist applauding so hard. Well, Take it easy, Pop, because they'll be coming back again tomorrow and playing a new team and maybe become champions one more time and keep adding to that wonderful total. We'll see what happens when these two kids come back to play another game of Beat the Clock tomorrow at the same time. Bye-bye, everybody.